your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks!
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Card Sharks. We're glad you could join us today. The holidays are over. We're settling into life again, and we're playing Card Sharks, and we're glad you're with us. I want to tell you, we have a new truck to give away. Like Charlie O'Donnell told you, we have lots of money. We have two very lovely dealers. Why don't we meet them right now? Here they come. Our dealers on Card Sharks are Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Listen to them whistling.
What a nice crowd.
You hear them whistling?
We hear that.
They're whistling for me.
I know you were going to say that.
If you'll deal out the cards, we'll get our card sharks in here. Come on, you guys. Sudah and Ike. How are you this morning?
Hi, Bob.
Fine.
Welcome back, Sudah.
Yeah, thank you.
$4,250 is what our champion has won so far. And Sudah is originally from India. And you now live?
In Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas. That Indian accent with a Texas accent is going to be real funny before this is over. Now, you married?
Yeah, I'm married, and I'm a housewife, and I have a beautiful daughter and a smart husband, and I go to school.
You have a smart husband.
And I go to school.
Does he go to school?
No, he's a computer engineer in AMD.
Oh, no kidding. Mm-hmm. Wow. Hey, Ike, how are you?
Oh, real good.
Tell us about Ike.
Well, Ike's from San Diego. He's married to a wonderful wife named Connie and a beautiful daughter named Anna Marie. I'm promotional director for a resort firm in San Diego.
Great. Well, it's nice to have you guys back. We're going to pick it up where we left off yesterday. Yesterday, we were in the middle of game number one. I was ready to ask the second question. That question will go to Ike. Remember, if you win two games, you're our champion. And let me tell you, today we've got some special guys with us today. We have some guys. These are 10 married men. They're married now. But they've all been married three times or more, and they're with us all this week. So, guys, won't you please join us? All right. Been married three times or more, and they're still smiling. Isn't that amazing? Ike, before the show, we asked these 10 guys, when you were single and dating, did you ever lie to a date about how many times you've been married? How many of these 10 men have lied to a woman about how many times they've been married?
Bob, that's a real tricky question. How many 10 men have lied?
No, not before? How many 10 men. How many of these guys?
How many of the 10?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, see, I was married once, and then I had that single time in between, and I lied a little bit. Okay, so I'd say it'd be a low number like four.
You've been married twice, then.
Right.
You're playing the little leagues compared to these guys.
Right. They're big leaguers, but...
So what do you think?
Okay.
So how many times have you been married?
Just once.
Once. I see. Oh, I didn't mean to ask a bad question.
I think...
The entire country of India just turned us off.
I think it's going to be a little bit higher.
A little bit higher, okay. The actual number of these men who have lied to a woman about how many times they've been married is... Three of them. No, not higher. It was a little bit lower. Which three of you guys have lied? Raise your hand if you would, please. There's still one missing. Oh, okay. Which three? Raise your hand. Oh, okay. Alex. Yeah, Alex. Why did you lie?
I'll tell you the truth, Bob. I think the show has ruined my marriage permanently.
This show has ruined your marriage?
The show has ruined my marriage. Because until last night when I got called to the show, my wife didn't know I'd been married two times before.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Alex. How much do you get paid? How much do you get paid to come on this show, Alex? Alex, how much do you get paid to come on this show?
Nothing.
Okay, you get paid nothing, right? So for an appearance on television, you would tell your wife that you've been married two other times, right?
I told her last night for the first time.
That's what I mean. You're a real ham, Alex. You know that? You really are.
You're a lousy liar.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it very much. Oh, anyway, see, just to get on television. What are you going to do about this, Ike?
Change it.
Well, okay. Let's see what we got. Nine is now five.
Higher.
Higher than the five. Seven.
Higher.
Hey, he's going on. No. Oh. Yeah, doggone. Sudah, free chance here,
can
all right?
Change it?
No, you can't change it.
Higher.
Higher than the seven. No. Not higher than the seven. Doggone. Okay. We'll be right back with more card sharks right after this. Now, Sudah, I've got a question for you, okay?
Yeah.
This is an educated guess question. Take a look at those cards over there. How many pounds does a deck of Card Shark cards weigh?
Yeah, well, I'm about 130 pounds, so it should be around...
You're how much, huh?
No.
You're 130 pounds?
Mm-hmm. Huh. So it should be around... Oh, my God, it's going to be about 7 pounds.
7 pounds, mm-hmm. All right.
I'm going to say higher, Bob.
I think it's higher than that.
Them up, yeah.
Okay. The actual number of pounds a deck of cards... Let me explain before we go any further. You just picked them up. The reason that the contestants pick up the cards is because they cut the cards. That's why they pick the cards up. I want to explain that. Otherwise, people say, thank you. I know. I get a brownie point for that, folks. The actual number of pounds a deck of Card Sharks cards weighs is 23 pounds. Yes, it was considerably higher. Ike, change the five, Ike.
Change it.
All right. See what Lace has for you. Five is now a jack, right?
Lower.
Hey, let's go lower. Oh. Doggone. I get mad. See him get mad? Yeah. Sudah.
Higher. Higher.
Higher? Is it?
Yeah. Yeah, lower.
Lower, yeah.
Higher.
Higher than a seven. No. You guys have got to learn about this word. The word called freeze, you see. Okay, we're going to play sudden death now. Someone has to win the game on the next play of the cards. Control will really be important for you. And the question is for you, Ike. This is about women.
Okay.
You know a lot about women, obviously. We surveyed 100 women. We asked them, if you could hear all of the intimate secrets of Nancy Reagan or all of the intimate secrets of Joan Collins, who would you choose? How many women would rather hear all of the Nancy Reagan intimate secrets?
I'd say... 63 would rather hear Nancy Reagan.
I think 63 out of 100. What do you think, Sudah?
Well, I think, you know, Nancy Reagan is more interesting because she's an international figure and we all know her and we would like...
Joan Collins is an international figure, too.
But, you know, Nancy Reagan is the first lady and, you know, all those things like what she wears and from where does she get all her soap.
Joan Collins has been in Playboy magazine.
That's okay, but I think I'll be interested in Nancy Reagan. So what was the question?
How many women would rather hear all of the Nancy Reagan intimate secrets? He said 63, higher or lower than that?
I think it's going to be a little bit lower.
A little bit lower? Mm-hmm. Actual number of women who would rather hear all of Nancy Reagan's intimate secrets is 43. You're right, Sudah was a little bit lower. Okay, we're playing sudden death now. Sudah, these are your choices. You can change the seven and play it out. If you make a mistake, he wins the game. Or pass it on to old Ike over there. And if he goofs, you're going to pass it
I'm
on.
I'm going to pass
all
it.
All right, Ike, if you make a mistake, she wins the game. All right?
Right, okay.
Good luck to you. Here we go.
Ready? Lower.
Lower, it is.
Higher.
Higher than the eight, it is.
Lower.
If it's lower, you win game number one. Is it lower? Yeah. Boy, it just makes you so nervous, makes you sweat, doesn't it?
I know, it does.
I know, yes. You got $100, Ike.
Ike. That's more than I had when I came in.
That's exactly right. And you also have won the first game. If you win the next game, you'll have another $100.
And
a chance to go
more.
On and play a lot more.
Like
Sudah,
that.
You have to win this game.
Yeah.
Lacey's
going to
deal out cards from the same decks, and let's get it going right now. Mm-hmm. Questions for you, Sudah. Mm-hmm. You ever been to Las Vegas?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Once. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we surveyed 100 gamblers in Las Vegas, and we asked them, would you like to see gambling legalized in your own hometown?
Mm-hmm.
How many gamblers would like to see gambling legalized in their hometown?
Oh, I think that's... You know, a lot of people who go there and gamble would like to have gambling legalized in their own town. Because, you know, instead of going all the way to Las Vegas, they can ride their gamble. And so, you know, I think it's going to be a high number because, you know, or else why would they go to Las Vegas? They would be just at home without going any gambling or anything. So I think it's going to be a high number. Let me say about 64.
64 out of 100 gamblers would like to see gambling legalized in their hometown. Ike?
It's got to be lower. It takes the mystique off it if it's home.
It's fun to go to Las Vegas. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. The actual number of gamblers who would like to see gambling legalized in their own hometown is 38 of them. Yeah, it was lower. All right, Ike. There we go, Ike. First card's deuce.
Higher.
Higher, no.
Ooh.
Whoa. Bad luck. Sudah, free chance, my dear. See what we got for you. Queen.
Lower
than a queen. No. More bad luck. Can you believe that? We will return in just a moment, folks. Don't go away.
Really been crazy.
We're going to continue now with game number two between Sudah, our champion, Ike, our challenger. And Ike, the next question is yours.
Okay.
We surveyed 116 year-old girls.
Oh, okay.
You know, okay.
Okay. Go ahead.
Weirdo. We asked them, do you think it's important for a girl to be a virgin when she marries? How many 16-year-old girls think being a virgin is important?
Ooh, morals have changed since I grew up. I think that the number would be low in today's society, and I'm going to go with 24.
24. See what Sudah says about this.
Yeah, in a way, I have to agree with him, because in India, we are virgins until we get married. Until we are, you know, even if you are get married at 30 years, you are a virgin until then. No way you can get married, you know, without being a virgin. And so virginity is very, very important in our culture.
So if you're 40 years old and you get married, it's a pretty short ceremony, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Yeah. I think it is very, very important to be a virgin before getting married, because, you know, it brings out the pureness in you. Don't you think so?
Oh, well, I don't know. I've never been a virgin. I don't know.
But anyhow, I think it's going to be a little bit higher than what I expect.
A little higher. Mm-hmm. Okay. That was an interesting question, wasn't it? The actual number of 16-year-old girls who think it's important for a girl to be a virgin when she marries is 29 of them. It was just a little bit higher. Oh. Sudah, want to keep
lower.
That card? Oh, he's going to keep it and go lower. All right, is it? Yes. Lady says no. Wow. Okay, free chance with Ike.
Higher.
Here we go, Ike. Three.
Higher.
Higher again, Ace.
Lower.
Lower, you got it.
Higher.
You're going to be our new champ. If it's higher, it is. Ike. Oh, congratulations to you. We've really enjoyed having you with us. You end up with $4,250 to
this.
Thank you very much.
I enjoyed it.
I'm glad you did. Bye-bye. Come on, Ike. Here we go.
Right on.
Whoop, right there.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, you stand right there. That's where the champion always stands.
Okay.
You ever see the champion stand over here? The champion never stands over here. He's
okay.
Always right there.
I'm right here.
And then they turn and face like this because,
okay.
See, those two lovely ladies have a deck of cards. You cut a little earlier. They're going to start dealing out those cards. Pay attention to me, Ike. And let me remind you of a couple of things. You can change one card per line. Minimum bets are $50 each time. And also, you'll be playing with our money. Pay attention to me, Ike. Thank you. So could we give him $200, please? There you go. Okay, Ike.
Okay.
Here we go. You got $200. You stay right there now. Don't move.
Okay.
We're the champion, Stan.
Okay.
You're the champion.
I got it.
All right. First card happens to be an ace.
Ace. Lower.
How much?
The whole thing. Lower.
Oh, I knew you'd say that, yes. All of it lower, and it is. Now you got $400.
Change it.
Which one do you want?
Two.
Number two. All right. Ike, let me see what we got. Nine becomes an ace again.
The whole thing lower.
Lower again. Look what we got. Whoa!
Three. The whole, how much have I got?
$800.
$800. Four higher.
Oh,
no.
Ike.
Okay. Hold it.
I don't
change?
Want to talk you out of it either.
Can I change?
Sure you
the
do.
Whole thing higher.
You're going to bet it all higher.
Okay.
Is it higher? Yeah! $1,600 up here. Give another $400. You got $2,000.
Four. Change that card.
You're gonna change the four.
Yeah.
Okay. Which one you want?
One.
Number one. Okay. Ike is playing the game differently than anybody's ever played it
That's
before.
Okay.
The four is a deuce. He knows what to do.
The whole thing higher.
Yeah, I like Ike's way. Higher. He's betting it all. There you are. $4,000, Ike.
Six. 100 higher.
100 higher. You ought to write a book about the way you do this. Is it higher than the six? Yeah, it is.
Okay.
4,100.
400 lower.
Oh, you're going to bet $100 on a six, but bet 400 on a nine. Okay. Here we go. 400 lower than the nine. No.
Oh,
back to 3,700, but look what you got up here.
Ooh.
Now tell me, Ike, I want to know honestly.
Sorry?
I don't know how you play this game, but did you want to change the king?
No.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to go 3,000 lower.
3,000 lower.
Right.
Let's see if it's lower. $3,000 lower than the king. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. 6,900 is what your total winnings are. Now, we're not done, all right? That's a very unusual way you play the game, but it obviously works. I'll tell you that. Now we're going to give you a chance to win a new truck. God knows what he'll do with this one, but take a look. This is the truck that you win. Charlie?
The exciting Toyota four-wheel drive deluxe V6 sport truck, great for on- and off-road driving. Comes with standard features, California emission, and more. Bob, back to you.
Thank you. All right, Ike. Come over here now. Now, you remember those 10 guys down there, 10 married right. guys, been married 3 times or more? Right. I'm going to ask you a question about them, then I'll ask you to go over there and place register your answer on our range board, all right?
Okay.
So, Susanna has the question. If you excuse me, Ike, I'll be right back. I'm back, Ike.
Thank you. I got you.
The champion does stand over here sometimes, doesn't he?
Yeah, it does. I was over there.
Before the show, we asked these 10 men down there, was your first wife your high school sweetheart? How many of these 10 men said their first wife was their high school sweetheart? Now, I want you to go over there and place the marker on your answer, please. How many of our 10 married men who've all been married 3 times or more said that their first wife was their high school sweetheart? You say 7 of them. Wow. If you're right, if it is 7, you win the truck.
Okay.
If you're off by 1, if the correct answer is 6 or 8, then you get another $500. The actual number of these men whose first wife was their high school sweetheart is 3 of them. No. But that's okay. We're not going to have to hold any charity dinners for you. You got $6,900, my friend. And we'll be back in just a moment to meet a new challenger for Ike right after this. New challenger for you. And Stacy, why don't you please come in here and join us on Card Shark.
Hi, kid.
Hi, Bob.
How
you doing?
My name's Stacy Pacheco, and I'm from San Diego. I have a lot of different roles. I'm a wife, a mother of a 1.5-year-old boy, a student at University of San Diego, and a bartender. And
today's
my mom's birthday. Happy birthday, Mom.
Yeah. So you're Stacy Pacheco.
Right.
With 4 occupations.
Right.
And you have a beautiful son.
Right.
Yeah, see, no one ever has an ugly baby, so I'm still looking for one, you're saying.
My mom asked me.
Okay. My mother had an ugly baby, and I'm an only child. if you win 2 games, you're our champion. We're going to get it going.
Right.
You got the cards dealt out. Good. Way to go, Lace. Oh, boy. She's right on today. Here we go, Ike. First question is yours, and this question involves our 10 married men in our studio audience who have all been married 3 times or more. Now, Ike, before the show, we asked these 10 men, this time around, are you a much better husband? How many of these 10 men said that this time around they are? They're a much better husband.
I'd say that's a high figure, Bob. I'd say it'd be a 7.
7. Stacy, what do you think?
Oh, I think they're experienced a little bit higher.
Even higher than the 7?
Yeah.
Wow. Actual number of these men who said this time around they're a better husband is... 9 of them.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, obviously, there's 9 of these guys that have learned their lesson, but there's one that's still out there. Who is it? Who says they're not a better... Oh, J.D., you're not a better husband this time around.
No, I've been married 4 times, and I still like to look, and I still like to gamble. And if I had something like me, I'd kick it out.
If you had something like you, you'd kick it out.
I'd divorce it.
You divorce it.
You better believe it.
No kidding. Now, you like to look. What do you look at?
All females.
Is that right? J.D., you don't touch, though, do you?
No. No. Not unless I had a chance.
I see. Thank you, J.D. Okay. He is right. All right. Stacy, you ready? All right. We've got a card for you. It's a king.
All right. Lower.
Lower than that king? No. Oh. Not lower than the king. Ike's got a free chance at these cards. 3.
Higher.
Higher. Queen.
Lower.
Is it lower? Yes.
Higher.
He's going on.
Lower.
To win the game, if it's lower than the queen, is it? Yes, it is. Woo. Kind of makes you mad, doesn't it? It'd make me mad if I were.
A little
bit. All right, we'll be right back. We're going to set up for game number 2. Don't go away, folks. You guys, I'm sure, will be back. We hope that you'll be back. For Susanna Williams, Lacey Pemberton, Charlie O'Donnell's with us this week. I'm Bob Eubanks saying thank you very much for watching Card Sharks. Bye-bye.